start repeatedly conversation. And that tells us that developers correctly identify and call constructs, otherwise they risk changes. So now let's look at the process of how we build our products. So first of all, draw applications are deployed on your device and it is run on the production. And all of them that happens. And then the developer or user may report this bug to the bug tracking system in the form of bug reports. Okay, so this is the example of bug reports. Basically, you need to specify what has happened, reproducing steps, and the bugs in terms that have been exposed. And after that, once the developer receives a bug report, the first thing he or she might do is to try to reproduce this bug. So they need to validate that hey, this bug is dead. Okay. And then they will generate a patch to fix this bug. So that after they patch the software, and software can support the production. Okay. So this is kind of a process of how to resolve software bugs. Okay. However, reproducing bugs from bug reports is very challenging because the provided information is automated. Language and natural language can be inherently in process and off-input. And even we assume that developers can perfectly understand the value of the actual production can still be a challenge because somehow it may require developers to exercise many steps to reproduce the program. So this is another example, as you can see that here it simplifies a lot of steps that are required. And in this work, our goal is to help developers reproduce the bugs in the bug report of the database. So here is what we want to do. We wish to develop a user bugs so that even if we get a bug report, it can automatically synthesize a test script that will correctly run on top of the new device and in order to reproduce. In the meantime, we want to archive the reproducing steps in the network and we so that developers can reproduce them and understand what we have. And toward this end, we are introducing the collect form, which is used to synthesize test scripts from bug reports to reproducing bugs. And here we focus on Android apps because Android apps are very popular and widely used. And the domain of our, the scope of our work, is focusing on app crashes because crashes are of particular concern to developers since they can directly impact usability. So first, let's look at example bug report. So in this example, the reporter describes five steps. To reproduce the crashes in 5 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? And the goal of our research is to translate this sort of description into actual reproducing sequences in the form of test cases in order to do it. So actually, only the last 3 sentences are really important in this case. Okay? So, so first of all, so this is a random example. First of all, when we click the home button and it brings the app to its first screen, and we can see that there is only one clickable button. Okay, so when we click it, brings the app to the next screen, and we found that the automatic refresh button matches the first screen. So we click it, brings the app to the next screen, and the server button matches the second sentence. Then according to the bug report, we need to enter the input to this text box. So we enter it and click on OK. Brings the app to the next screen. Okay. And then we need to click the flash button so that the app crashes. translate the natural language interpreter into these actual systems in this case. But to achieve this goal, we must address several challenges. Okay, the first challenge is that what type of information to extract from an environment. And our insight was that events that trigger new activities or provide values are the key parts of the steps provided by the guide reports. And these events typically involve perform a action on a particular UI component with specific input elements. So that these three elements are the things that we need to extract out from guide reports. And then we formulate these three elements into a given tuple, what we call it semantic representations of events. And the second design challenge is how to extract such event representations from the background. Okay, and so a straightforward solution is to use a simple keyword search, right, to match each thing in the background report against the names appear in the add buttons to see that which button matches to the button. But the problem with keyword search is that it cannot reliably detect the syntactic relationships among actions, UI components, and inputs. Okay. So another issue with keyword search is that they cannot detect input values either, because input values don't match. So in this case, okay, if both show and show and the help words,
that's fine. You want to do that?
Two buttons on this thing.
I think I still have three left.
So we find out that hey, both of the buttons match with the double person with the help button to show the word, right? But in fact, only the show word matches against this button. Okay, so help is actually irrelevant. So our goal is to identify this help button on the street. So this is the limitation of the keyword search. Another problem is that the reporter may use a new word that is different from what he described as the what is described but here the button says moving, but the reporter may write I play the film. Okay, so by using a keyword search, we cannot detect this exact image. Okay. So to address these issues, we use the dependent comparison techniques in natural language processing to identify the grammatical structures among actions, UI components, and input values, and then derive a set of what we call grammar patterns, and later on we use these patterns to identify the given representations given new values. Okay, and then to bridge the lexical gap between the words inside the value reports and the words appeared in the UI components, we use word embedding computing by a word that model to determine whether two words are semantically equivalent. Because in that example, we can use the word embedding to tell that the movie is related to the film, right? So we can see that these two are related. Okay? And after identifying the event representations, we need to search for a complete reproducing sequence from app to reproduce the crash. Okay? But the challenge here is that in that report is likely to be incomplete. Because reporters may omit some steps that are thought are not important in the report, or they may just forget to write such steps. So our approach must be able to fill out these missing steps. By existing, there have been many existing UI crawling tools that can help us search for the sequences, but we believe that these tools traditional depth first traversal, so that they search for the sequences from beginning all the way to the end until no more available components are available before searching for the next sequence. But in our case, this can be suboptimal because once an incorrect UI component is chosen, like if the component is not relevant to the bug report is chosen, the subsequent exploration will be wasted. Okay, so we don't want to do that. Okay, so in this case, our solution is to use a guided depth first traversal with back tracking feature to guide the search. Okay, so in this case, guided by the bug reports, if none of the components are relevant to the bug reports, instead of deepening the exploration all the way to the end, so we can backtrack to a previous level that is relevant to the bug report. Okay, so the last challenge is concerned about efficiency. Because efficiency in the reproduction process is important for developer acceptance. Because an approach that takes too long may not worth the wait to developers. They have to wait there and wait there for the announcement. On the other hand, we want to generate a short sequence. Because a long test sequence may overwhelm developers since they need to. To what extent we design a set of the optimization strategies such as checking the equivalence of strings, detecting loops to avoid redundant search, and we also prioritize the UI components to explore in order to speed up the search, and in addition, we do efficient backtracking to reduce the size of the test sequences. Okay. So now let's look at the details of our approach. Has two major phases, bug report analysis and dynamic exploration. And to carry out bug report analysis, it uses the dependency parsing techniques from natural language processing to extract event representations. Okay? And then in the second phase, guided by the event representations, it can systematically explore a test sequence to reproduce. And the key idea that we use is called the dynamic algorithm tree that I will introduce. So now let's look at the first phase. And to derive grammar patterns, what we did is that we manually studied more than 800 Android bug reports. So for each sentence in a report, we analyze the dependencies among words and phrases inside sentences, and specifically we identify the part of speech cap of each word within the sentence, and we parse the sentence into clauses and label semantic roles. Okay? And in this example, we can see that the direct object of a click action is a UI component. Okay? And its associated noun phrase is also a UI component. So here we can identify that an easy level, all level, could be the complete true acronyms. And then we derive 22 grammar patterns in total for three types of actions, including click action, edit action, and the gesture action, a swipe, or rotate swing. Alright, and after that, in a bug report, record join parse the sentences, and then uses the grammar patterns to extract the representations. Okay. So it matches the first pattern and the nice pattern and a nice pattern again. So we can extract these elements in the form of hidden representations out. Okay. So our next step is to identify the short sequences of events to fully and automatically reproduce the reporting crashes. Guided by the extractive. Alright, so the key idea here is using a dynamic model in a tree to guide the search. Okay? So here each node in a tree is a UI component. And the edge represents the even transition from one screen to another by exercising this component. Okay? And we call this tree dynamic order. So why we call this tree dynamic order? Because it is dynamically built, the nodes, dynamically built during runtime, and the nodes are ordered according to the descending order of their relevance to the background. To order them according to their relevance to the background. Okay? And we see that a component is relevant. It matches the background part and it hasn't been explored before. And if it appears earlier in the background. Okay? And also we utilize a heuristic to determine whether a component is more dangerous than the other based on the frequency its appearance in the background. OK appears more frequently and cancel back, so it is naturally more dangerous. So here is an example. Okay. So suppose we have three components on the screen, and both B and C are relevant to the battery reports, but according to the ranking strategy, C is ranked earlier than B, so it is put on leftmost. Okay. So in this case, rank drop will always pick the leftmost node from. And another challenge that we encountered during the tool development is that grammar patterns actually work very well when the description, the sentences are well structured. Okay? But sometimes, you know, the description may contain grammar errors or it is not well structured. Structured or is very complicated, in this case grammar patterns may not work. Okay? And to address these challenges, we use n-grams to extract the grams from both battery reports and the app component states. Okay? And the n-grams is actually a consecutive n words. This is called two grams. Okay, so you can see that the two words fit together. So we extract these words. Okay, and then we do the comparison. We compare the grams of the UI components and the value. And another challenge we encounter is that the input values sometimes are not available for editable components. So what we did here is that we leveraged several heuristics. If the input values are not available for a particular component, values objective for the other components to see that we can reproduce this value. Okay? And otherwise, we try special symbols because we observe that special symbols are more likely to trigger the value than regular symbols. And otherwise, we just randomly send the value. Okay? So here is the example of our search algorithm. Okay? So first of all, on the left side is our inefficient conditions, okay? And then we start building this dynamic order tree. Okay, so the root node of the tree is the component on that screen, the current screen, since there is only, the root node of the tree is the home screen, okay, so we have to push the home button, okay? And then, it brings up to this screen called go to reference. Since there is only one button in the screen, even if it doesn't match with the value, we still need to create a node for this tree. Okay, so after exercising this component, it brings up to this screen. Okay, and we can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 buttons. Okay, and we as you can tell that automatic refresh matches the first configuration. So it is placed on the leftmost node of the tree. And then we run the rest of the nodes according to the relevance to the background. Okay. And then we take this node to explore, brings it up to next screen. Okay. And we can see that server matches the second configuration. Okay. And it is run instead of doing the search, we backtrack from the beginning, okay, and search for the next sequence, relevant sequence, for example. Okay. So at this point, you may wonder, hey, why don't you just backtrack to a previous step? Why you backtrack all the way from the top? The reason is because we want to reset the state of the app. So if we just backtrack to the previous level, it may cause state to diverge. That makes the app to take a different path to the speed. So we just want to completely clean up the state of the app. So in this case, we'll take the next most relevant component to that state. Okay. And what is the end of way? Utilize a set of optimizing strategies. So for example, like we can check the screen. So we consider two screens are equivalent. By clicking something, it always brings the screen to the same page again. So for example, like there is a flash button click that it can be executed again. So that way eliminate such screens in our dynamic operation. Okay. And then we can have loops in order to prune the tree to reduce the search space. And then by restarting the search and the resetting the state, we can minimize the sequence size, test the sequence size. Okay. And then we conducted an empirical study to answer many research questions. Okay, so I will just keep the details of these research questions because the answers to these questions are definitely yes, otherwise the paper will have trouble to get them. What we did here is that we spent a lot of time collecting the bug reports and mobile apps, and eventually we have 39 crash bug reports from 33 Android apps. And it turned out that we can detect more than 80% of crashes. And it is also efficient. On average, it takes about 4 minutes to finish. So there are some bug reports that we cannot reproduce the business because that our current implementation doesn't support either against this web or scroll actions. And it cannot handle concurrency or non-communistic bugs, and we are working on addressing these issues. So I'm going to skip the blessing risk question and just jump to the summary of the webdrum. So we have released these two as a publicly available tool so that people can replicate, reuse, and work. And also our tool has passed the artifacts evaluation at AT, because these days, our top tier conferences, and they have a new track called artifact evaluation track that actually encourage researchers to share their artifacts to our community. And naturally, we were awarded with two badges by ACM, both reusable and available, which means that it is functional and the public available. So we still have a few minutes left, and I want the lead author, one of my PhD students, to show a little bit of a demo of how that job works.
I have a question while we're setting up. Have you looked at Twitter-based bug reports?
No.
The parsing would be different.
So what do you mean the Twitter-based stuff? Is it like the Twitter app?
So people will tweet that
my
Libra news went down at Libra news.
Okay, it's like something that complain the issues that are happening.
Yeah,
that would be more difficult, I would say, because they may just complain without saying that how this bug is triggered. I don't know.
Possibly.
But in the worst case, that our tool will serve as a systematic exploration any keys, it's just search everything
right.
until you can find them that.
We're starting again from the very beginning.
Yes, because we want to keep the initial state. Because I found the issue. When I try to reproduce the buffer power, that is a game buffer power, and there is the options and delay the game. If my tool automatically try to delay the game, and the father node will be delayed. Then my tool will have the bug and the memory from the bug.
Last time it's starting over again. Mm-hmm. And this time it's in a day.
Yeah, it's quite a right. Crash.
Thank you very much. If there are more questions, you can ask.